it's me again.
Hello, it's me again. It's Wednesday. See, I'm doing better this time. And I have a box to open. Where's my scissors? I got everything and then forgot to make sure my scissors were here. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm in a different wheelchair. Probably can't tell. Maybe my headrest looks different. I don't know. But I'm going to show you guys. Here, turn it off. I want to show you guys what it looks like in a minute, but let's open this box. If I can find my scissors. Where the heck are my scissors? I might have to go in my other room and get my scissors because I'm silly and I did not make sure the scissors were in here. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, I'll be back. Just when I turned the camera off, I found my scissors. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and open this really quick before I point you guys down because the address and stuff's on the top. So I decided I'm not going to bother even trying the six wheel because I know that this is the one I want. It just feels lighter. I know it's not that much lighter, but it feels lighter and the suspension is amazing. It's like I go up over the bumps the suspension on my other wheelchair, my present wheelchair is good, but this is just amazing. So I already know what it feels like to drive a six wheel, so I don't need to get used to it. For this one, you drive, the wheels are in the back, the big wheels are right here up in the front. Also, it like powers over everything. Like, I have not been in my backyard since we moved into this house. We built this house, and when I had my, it's called the Invacare Storm, and it's kind of a big all-terrain kind of a chair. I bought it actually used because there was too much time in between the junky wheelchair that I had before and getting my wheelchair that I have now, my Quantum, my big six wheel. So we just went ahead and got that one just so I could go out because they gave me a bunch of wheelchairs to try, and then it was going to take a long time to get a new one because it wasn't the whole 5 years, because the one I had before was one that you kind of take apart and put in the car, and we didn't know enough about wheelchairs at the time because I went from a manual chair to this electric chair that is terrible. It's mainly for old people to be in the house in, because you go over any bump and it just kick you backwards. Like, backwards, like, onto the ground backwards. Fortunately, I was caught every time that happened, but it was terrifying to go over bumps. So there's no way I would ever have been able to get up the hill or anything. I could get out we have, like, big sliding doors, and I could get over the door with the Storm because it's like more all-terrain, had big wheels in the front and then the big drive wheels were in the back, so it was a four wheel, but it was different, it didn't have small wheels. And when I try with my Quantum, Quantum's pretty good, it's strong chair, you know, it'll get me, like, I can go like kind of four wheeling with it and stuff. But when you get the two front little drive wheels over, or not drive wheels, the little casters over the thing, it turns sideways, so I get stuck in the door sideways, so I cannot get out the door, and I didn't want to like tear up my doors and tear up my wheelchair, so I just gave up. But this thing just went boom right over it, went right out in the in the yard, and the bumps in the yard didn't bother me because we have a lot of divots because we didn't really level out our yard. It's got nice grass back there, but what we did is we put like lots of cardboard and stuff down, and that's biodegradable, just goes into the ground, but it blocks all the weeds and stuff from coming up, and once the roots and stuff were dead, they like dug that and planted like grass. So it's not the best grass in the world, but it's better than it was before. It was just all like nettles, you know, those things that sting you. There still are some nettles over. We have 1 acre of land, so anyway, it's nice to be outside. And then I could complain to my husband how much he needs to clean up the backyard. So Anyway, that's that. Let's look at this box I have here. Here, let me put you guys up. Here we go. Okay. So I got some hair. This is some more hair. I have some black curly hair already. Ow! I have some black curly hair already from that I had bought. It's the same. It's HP Baby Locks. So I got some more for Benjamin. For my little Benjamin over here. My little brown Benjamin with brown eyes. So this is Annie by Lily Gold. So she is, let's see, 46 out of 2000. I just fell in love with her. She is so cute. I'm going to be real particular about buying, like, little babies from now on. I had to be careful because I'm popping my finger out. My thumb. Okay. Because I want to do more toddlers and, like, larger babies. Because I tend to be better with those. But my Laura came out good, so I was happy about her. But I'm going to do less little babies and more bigger babies and toddlers. But this one I had to have. Look at that face. I love this face. She is so cute. She's got lots of nice details and contours in her head. I need that. I want to see these little hands. Oh. She's got nice detail on her hands. That's her little fist. Why'd we get so dark all of a sudden? Mm-hmm. Are we okay? Yep. Yeah. Okay. So, you can see the detail in her hand, in her wrist, back of her. Look, she's got muscle. Working out. Okay, let's look at the other little hand, little arm. Oh, so cute. Okay, there's some little weirdness up here. It looks cute on that side, but you see that? You can see it through the fingers. So that's kind of weird, but I don't care. I like it anyway. Because, I mean, that looks good. This side. It's just that you can see it through the fingers on this side. But it's okay. There's some detail here. There. No muscle on this side. She's got to work out this arm too. And here's her cute little spindly legs. I love cute little spindly legs. You know, the detail. And her foot. All the little creases and crinkles. Look at the back of her heel. And the bottom of her foot. There's her little knee. Because, like, you know, newborns have little, most of them have little skinny legs. I mean, there are some that are chunky still. I'm just looking. There's a detail in her foot. Her heel. Bottom of her foot. Toesies. You guys can see in there. Underneath. Her knee. You see that little divot there. She's pretty nice. She kind of reminds me of Delilah and Laura in a way with the details. Oh. We got a snacky. I'll have to give that to Maddie. I don't need any snackies right now. I've had enough snackies. So I'll put her away. I'm almost tempted to do her instead of the other baby, but I'm going to do the other baby. Okay. So. Yeah. This thing, I need to put some oil on it or something. Okay, so hot all of a sudden. I'll be back. Hello. So we're gonna paint Cameron tomorrow. So I'm gonna use a violet because he still has a lot of yellow. I haven't put any yellow on him yet, but his kit is pretty yellow. So it's a golden ultramarine violet. All right. There we go. Sorry for the arm. All right. So I have Annette was asking the difference. This are my powders that I use. I also use the pan pastels, which I have mixed up with I'll show you guys that when we do the other baby. So I'm going to use the pan pastels for the mini baby. But these are Coastal Scents, they went out of business. But it's basically matte eyeshadows. And Sue Ellen, the artist from Australia, who I can't think of the name of her thing right now. But I'll put it in the description. I put it in there before, but her Patreon, she teaches you how to use the paints. She's Ultimate Fusion paints, so she teaches you how to use the Ultimate Fusion paints with the powders, and she uses a different kind of powders now, a different kind of eyeshadow, and I put that in the description before too, but I can see if I can find it. So this is just going to be a wash, so we're just going to brush it on and then pounce it off like we did with the blue. So this will help even out the color a little bit because he's still really yellow. His kit is just really yellow. I'm just kind of pouncing it in so it looks even. I just use regular kind of cheap makeup brushes. These are like kabuki brushes. These are really good for pouncing in like darker colors because it keeps it from getting all streaked and like the browns and the blues and stuff is really good for those colors. To get inside the ears with the bigger brush. Well, bigger, you know, small brush. I use my smaller brushes for little details and the bigger brushes for the bigger areas. I'm going to just go all over the face, even across the lips and everything, just to help tone down this yellow a little bit. Here we go. You want to make sure everything's even, there's no streaks or lines or anything. Hair there. When you're painting with any paints, you gotta watch out for little fuzzies and hairs, but they like to really stick to the air dry paints. But you know, I've seen close-ups of some Genesis babies that have little hair stuck in their paint too, so it happens with any kind of paint. You can get little fuzzies in the air, little dust particles and stuff stuck in your baby's paint, so you need to be watchful of that. There, he's looking better now. gonna go around his face with the his ears again with the smaller brush. That looks better. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and put this violet on him, and then we'll see what else he needs. I think I might do some powders on him, and I'll come back and show you what it looks like when it's dry. Okay, so we got all the purple on Mr. Cameron, and I know this is going to sound really silly, but I'm going to do a little bit of powders, and then I'm going to put some yellow ochre on. And I know it sounds weird, but it's because it's a different yellow. It's more of a flesh tone kind of yellow. Anyway, I have all my brushes over here. This is what I use for one red, so I'm going to use for another red, and then I have this is the brush I'm going to use to like kind of. I have my sponge to rub it in, and I have my little brush to rub it in. So, and then I have my yellow and my blue. So, basically just to do powders, I'm going to use this darker. This is a red wine or something. Anyway, it doesn't matter because these powders are no longer in existence. They are sold out. The company went out of business because of COVID, I guess. Oh, that's kind of sad because it's really good. I mean, they're, like I said, they are eyeshadows, but they're really good. They're highly pigmented matte powders. They work really good with the paint. So basically what I do is I go around the creases. I don't set my powders, but when I do on the little baby, I'm going to try something. I'm going to actually try it on one of my test heads first, but with the my pan pastels when we do the little newborn. I'm going to follow April Yap's tutorial, who is the first, that's how I learned how to use them in the first place, but I never sealed them. I have a sealer. Where is it? I think it's down on the bottom. Anyway, I'll show it to you guys. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put it in a spray bottle, the sealer. It's a Reborn FX sealer. And I'm going to spray it on a sponge. And then I'm going to set the powders so they don't wash away. Because the way I do it right now, I do a kind of dark, and then when I do another wash, it kind of washes away some of the powder, and then I just reapply them because I think it looks more natural. But with the pan pastels, it's kind of different, so it's okay to go ahead and seal them. And I'm putting a little bit in the ears. He doesn't have very detailed ears, but we'll kind of try to make them look nice. I'm going to get another brush out so I can put a little bit of dark in there. Get behind the ears in this little crease. So on the, I'll show you what I do on the fingers and the toes before I shut off the camera because I don't want to just go around and do the whole thing and bore the heck out of you guys. I'm going to use this brush to rub that in and back here instead of the sponge because the sponge won't reach as well. I got some new brushes. So my older brushes were getting kind of frayed and bad, so I got rid of a bunch of them and I got some new ones. I like this one a lot because it's like a little tiny mop brush, sort of. So I can get into tiny places and kind of push the powders in. Because these eyeshadows, of course, wash away way easier than the pan pastels do. Sometimes if you get too dark with the pan pastels, you need to use an eraser, like an actual eraser. I'll show you the kind I use. It's like clay. You can pull a piece off of it, and that's easy to get up into the creases. So if you kind of mess up and do a little too dark. So you might want to get one of those. It's like an artist eraser. If you're doing pan pastels with me, when we do the newborn baby. And you guys can do, like, you know, if you're already an artist and you have your own kind of thing that you like to do, you know, go, you know, do that. I'd love to see pictures of everybody's babies that is going to paint with me afterwards. That'll be fun. My email, if you hit the about button, you'll find my email so you can email me pictures of your babies. And maybe I can make like a little montage of everybody's baby. If that's okay with you guys. If you guys are okay with showing your baby. I can put it in the video at the end. I've decided, I think, that I'm going to paint Serena and Annie. Because I'm in love with Annie and I really want to paint her. So I'm going to do two babies. And I'm going to go under the nose a little bit and around this crease here. Because he's got kind of deep creases under his nose, you guys can see. So I want to kind of highlight those in a way. Get underneath there. This is a good brush for that. Because I don't want it just to look like a line. And sometimes with the pan pastels it looks that way. Which is why I switched to these. But I know how to use the pan pastels. So if you guys don't want to use pan pastels and you'd rather use, like, if you have eyeshadows or whatever, just use those. I'm gonna go around his lips like lip liner. Go around his little blister and go over it a little tiny bit. I don't want too much red on his blister. There, you can see his lips are starting to look more realistic. It's another thing why I like to do the powders kind of early. And in April Yap's tutorial, she said to do the whole, like, flesh tone. Get, you know, everything done before you put on the powder, so I don't know if I'm completely comfortable with that, so we'll see. I might actually use a little bit of my powders and then put the pan pastels on at the end. Because I'm kind of worried about that. I don't wanna mess up my babies. Oops, wrong brush. I'm gonna put this one down in case I stick that one in my powder. Well, that's not the right red. I'm talking and not paying attention to what I'm doing. I actually like this red. If you do like the darker red first for blush, if you go over it with that red. I think who did I do that on? Did I do it on Oliver? I think. I know somebody used a lot of this pomegranate red, and it came out really good. I think it depends on the colors of the vinyl. Go. See, I did the crease underneath his little crease in his little neck. Okay, so now I'm gonna do a little bit of this. I can do the yellow. I'm gonna do some on the tip of his nose. As a and on his ears. A lot of people, like, you can't tell as much, like on your nose, but your nose is more yellow, you know? So you kind of gotta sort of artificially make their nose a little more yellow. Okay, that looks good. Geez, little yellow nose. I used to go a little crazy with the yellow, but also I had my yellow turned up on my camera because I was watching a video with a guy. So he turned up the yellow on his camera to help with his, even his skin tone or something. I don't remember. But I did not need the yellow turned up like that. So I found another, tutorial. So that's why my baby's noses don't look as yellow. But when I first started doing it, I did add too much yellow. But when I was doing my channel, you know, I kept saying, geez, my baby's noses look so yellow. And it was because of the setting that I had on my camera. It wasn't because I actually did put too much yellow on there. There we go. Okay, now we're going to do blue. So the blue would go inside the eye right here, down into that crease. I have another blue. I'm fortunate that I didn't know they were going out of business, but I bought quite a few. This is my old fine wine, that's what it's called. I have this paprika color, and this is also an old one that I pulled out. And I have another cornflower blue, which is that one. So, but I do know which powders I'm switching to. But I don't mind using the, what did I do with my brush? There it is. I don't mind using the pan pastels too. I just like these better because they're easier to work with. They're not so harsh. They, you know, you can just build them up. That's I like building up color rather than just putting color. If that makes sense. Oh, not that one. I do like this one for veins, especially on darker babies. It's called Electric Blue. And sometimes I use that even on lighter babies. You know, if I want some darker, I'm gonna brush that with this brush. There we go. Okay, as you can see, the blue in between his eyes. And I also go over the bridge of the nose. And you have to do that several times because the blues really don't show up. Now I'm gonna go like right under his nose right here in this little space. Just hold them upside down so I can see where it's going. There we go. And a lot of this is, like I said, is going to like wash away when I do the washes, but I reapply if I want it darker again. And this is also why I push it in with the sponge. So some of it will stay there. Otherwise, the whole thing would just wash off. And put right under, especially when they have a deep lip like that. And put the little bit of blue right underneath there. Kind of highlights the lip. This little space right here, I forgot to tell you, I put a little bit of red there. It's called the Cupid's bow. You want to be careful with that, because if you put it too dark, it'll look more like a cleft. So, if you want to make a cleft in the lip, you can do that too. I've seen a lot of people really make it look really realistic. It's pretty cool. Like over on the side, you know, like a little cleft lip. I have not tried doing that, but I've seen people do it and it looks really, really amazingly real. Oh, I forgot to put the yellow on the ears. I put the yellow like in this cartilage part right here. There we go. I'll do a little bit here. I'm going to put this red around the top of the ear I'm singing a Casey and the Sunshine Band song. Song stuck in my head. Please don't go. Okay. So there's the ear so far, and I am going to put like a little dark spot in there. I'll show you in a minute. Let me get this ear done. Bit on the balls of the cheeks. You don't want to put too much blush yet. Just put it like right on the you know, the place where you'd pinch. You're so cute. Oh, you've grown so much. You know. And a little tiny bit on the chinny chin chin. Okay. Get a little bit up here. I'm going to put some blue up there too. There we go. And then we'll put some blue up here in these little spaces here. On a smaller baby, they have more like thin skin around their head and stuff. So you can highlight that more. And he's a younger baby, so he would still have that kind of thin skin. And a really tiny baby would have even more. And some even older babies, like real pale babies, they have a lot of thin skin still. Like even when they're like, you know, 2 years old, 3 years old. Okay. I'm gonna get in here with that too. I like his grumpy face. Okay. I'm gonna get another brush here just to put. Okay, I wanna get kind of a more stiff brush like that. So I'm gonna go here and it's called Deep Roast. I'm just gonna barely touch in there because I want it to look like he has, you know, a hole in his ear, which is hard to do with some ears. Some ears go pretty deep in there, but some are just hard to make look, you know, more realistic. Okay. I'm gonna get another brush to rub that. This is one of my more frayed brushes, but this is kind of like a rubbing brush. So I'll have to do that a couple more times because it doesn't look too dark yet. And like I said, I don't want to, this is just like preliminary kind of work. But you can see, you know, it's more dark in the ear now, in the ear canal. And I'm going to do the same thing in his nose. Let me see if this brush is too big for his nose. Yeah. Get a smaller one. I think I'm gonna have to use this one of these teeny tiny ones. I use these for I have two of them. They're very, very tiny. It's hard to see. I use it for veins, which I'm gonna show you in just a second. But right now I'm going to where's my other one? I have another one. Need to go up the nose. I'm going to use this one for the veins. Put a little bit of this Deep Roast in here and move it around inside. Because I also want his nose to look like it has. It's pretty dark actually. Let's see. I can have a brush that I can stick in there to move that around. See, most of that came out. You can see kind of dark in his nose now. Okay, so I've done one hand and one foot, So let's start with the hand, actually. So where's that little brush? I'm going to use, again, this dark color to go over all of the little creases in the fingers. And then we rub that in. I'm just going all over these little creases, and then I'm going to brush them in with the sponge. There's some creases you don't really want to highlight all that much, so you just kind of gloss over them or just do it really lightly. Like, you know, the creases under the eyes, you don't want to do those really, like, dark red or anything. Make your baby look like shit. Then it's slept in a while. It's you that'll look like that, not the baby. I'm gonna do the fingertips with this color. I can't remember what that color is. Doesn't matter though, because it, like I said, they don't make these anymore anyway. And they're not sold anywhere unless someone's selling them from when they were reborning and decided not to use them or something. Again, make sure you get the tips of the fingers. I'm also going to go over the nail beds in the backs of the... I already did that with the dark. I'm going to do it with the lighter red now. In between the fingers. Let's get up here on the tips of the fingers. There we go. Okay, now we're gonna get this part. Remember that we did before in this part of the hand, this part of the hand. See, my hand is red there, which is why I do it on my babies. I'm matching them to me. I'll put a little bit on the elbow. I think I put some paint on one elbow and not the other, but we'll get it to even out. It doesn't have to be perfect anyway. Okay. So I got all these little creases. Let me get this one again. You don't want, like, these creases to be, like, really dark either. There we go. See that? That's pretty simple. And then we're gonna do the foot. So it's basically the same thing. We just go in between the toes with the darker color. I'm gonna be sad when all my pan pastels are gone. I have a bunch of them that I don't even use, like some of these colors up here. I sometimes use this green. This has like got too much red on it and stuff. And there's these dark colors. These would be good for like a darker baby, but I rarely ever use those colors. But so I'll keep those around, you know, to use when I get the new eyeshadows, powders, whatever. Or I might just decide to use my pen pastels more often. I don't know what I'll do. I'll figure out something that I feel, you know, happy with doing. So one thing about like tutorials, like, oh, that was good. I'm paying attention to what I'm doing. With tutorials, I personally can't follow a tutorial. I like pick things from a tutorial to use. But I pretty much learned how to paint by just kind of trial and error, trying certain things and trying things that people, you know, suggest. And so a lot of my stuff, a lot of the techniques I use are maybe borrowed from somebody or I made them up. Like the way I mix my paint, I don't know that. I know a lot of people use satin glazing liquid. I don't know how many people use the wetting agent, but I like the way it makes the paint kind of glide over the, it makes it more like kind of like oil paints because it glides over the vinyl easier. Because when you use just straight acrylic paint, it can leave like streaks because it dries up and doesn't move. And I like to move my paint around on my pieces. Some people just use the back of a sponge, like, you know, and just pounce it on like that, but I don't think it looks that great. At least for me, it doesn't. Things work for other people that don't work for me. And vice versa. Okay, where's my... There it is. Okay, so we're going to do the little toesies. You can see that I'm... Got to be more careful. Powders are flying through the air. I don't want that to get stuck on... I'm trying to hold it so you guys can see it, but I don't want to put a bunch of little tiny particles all over the head and stuff. Okay. I'm going to brush that away. Get that on the tips of the toes. Now we're going to do here. Brush that away. Some down here. And on the sides of the pads of the foot. Like I said, this part of powders is building up colors because I'm going to reapply the powders later on. So everything in the early stages is just building up color. Okay. Get this other side. Where's the other brush? There it is. I do across the toes on the back and in between the toes. Okay, so sorry about that. My camera died again. This doesn't warn me when my camera's going to die, so my new battery doesn't communicate or something. But we finished this other foot. You didn't miss much. Just did the veining and stuff. So when we come back, we're going to do what does he need? Let's look. I think we'll go ahead and he still looks really yellow. Maybe we'll do I did violet, so I might do either another violet or maybe we'll just go straight purple. See if we can, because yeah, he still looks really yellow, so I'm hesitant to put a yellow coat on him yet. But well, he needs some yellow in his skin. That's okay. So I might even put a flesh coat on him. Something new that I started doing. Hello. Okay. I'm just gonna end the video. I just want to show you guys a couple things. Cameron has had a flesh coat, which is just buff, a little bit of buff white paint. This stuff. And some red P pink. So, he looks kind of washed out right now, so we'll get back to him. I darkened his lips just a little bit. I want to show you this new outfit that I got really quick. Bought a bunch of stuff on AliExpress so far. This is the only thing that's come. This is for a toddler. It's cute. It's got pink and purple and blue. Little blueberries. Okay. So, hello, it's me in my bed again. I'm just putting some eyelashes on little Mr. Timothy. He needs some eyelashes. Focus. There we go. He's so cute. And his little hair. So, doing that. And I'm going to go back to routine. My little Maylin. I'm rooting her hair with human hair. It's not going to be this long, but sort of long. Anyway, I just forgot to tell you, I'm going to put a little video from my beautiful, lovely customer and friend, Beverly. She, I made her a Susu, I made her a Maggie, and now she has a Bren. So, my last custom. So, I hope you guys enjoy that. It's not a box opening, it's just, she got the baby and she just talking about her, and so I'm gonna put that right here, right now. Hello everybody, this is Beverly, and I just got Brenna Mae today from April Angard of Reborns by Zebra. I just did the saran wrap off of her hair, but I have to say, I think she's even cuter in person. She's got beautiful blue eyes and beautiful strawberry blonde hair, dramatic lips, and I think, you know, I wasn't sure about cutting the hair, but I can see now what the little baby toddler look that April was going for, and she's really cute. I'm really happy with her. I'm going to get some different angles. Here she is, looking out the window saying, "Where am I? What is this strange place called America?" And I haven't done anything with her hair yet, so I will. But I just wanted you to see her. And let's have her look this way now. Say hi, Brenna Mae. Hello there, sweetie. Yes, you made it in a very short amount of time. And you're very cute. And I just wanted everybody to see your sweet little face. Okay? Say bye-bye for now. See you later. Thank you very much, April. She's just precious. Thank you.
I'm going to end the video here, and I'm going to go ahead and upload early. So if you guys like what I do, please like and subscribe. My son's being really loud. And go get some paint and a doll kit and paint a doll. It's fun. Okay, bye. An authentic doll kit.